In developmental psychology, the main goal is to investigate how people stay the same over the course of their lives and also how people change over the course of their lives. And so because we have this element of aging and of time, we need to use some different methods than we would in other fields of psychology. So earlier in the semester, we learned about other methods, so things like case studies, naturalistic observation, archival research, surveys, experiments, and so on. And all of these are still valid in developmental psychology. It's not that we are getting rid of these methods, but we're adding to it, we're kind of overlaying two additional methods or two main methods to help us get at that element of time. And those are longitudinal and cross-sectional research. And we're going to go over each one in a moment. But the main thing to keep in mind is that those two new methods are not replacing the others. Instead, think of it as a column A and a column B. So you can have a longitudinal case study, a longitudinal survey, a longitudinal experiment. Or you could have a cross-sectional survey, a cross-sectional experiment, and so on. And there are other developmental research methods, but they are all just variations on these two. So let's start with longitudinal research. The main idea behind this method is that you take one group of people who are all the same age, and you study them over some chunk of time. This could be months, it could be years, it could be decades. So the advantage of this is that you're studying the same change in the same people over time. So you get to actually compare one person's data at an older age with their own data from a younger age. But the downside is that this takes a lot of time and it takes a lot of money. And you have the risk that participants will either die or they'll just drop out of your study. And for whatever reason, maybe they don't want to be in your study anymore. Maybe they move and they don't give you the forwarding address. Could be a lot of reasons. So this is a wonderful method to use. It gives us a lot of really good data, but it does have some downsides. So very often what researchers will do instead is what's called a cross-sectional study. And in a cross-sectional study, you go out at one point in time and you compare groups of people of different ages. So I might go out today and find a group of 10-year-olds, a group of 20-year-olds, and a group of 30-year-olds. The advantage is everything that you don't have with the longitudinal research. So it's cheaper, it's quicker, and you don't have to worry about people dying or dropping out. But we do have to worry about what are called cohort effects. And a cohort effect means that if we see differences between the people in those different age groups, maybe it's age that made the difference, but maybe it's because those people grew up under different social and historical and economic circumstances. So for example, if I were to go out today and I measure attitudes about social media, and I survey people who are age 10, age 20, age 30, and so on up to age 80, if I find that 10-year-olds and 80-year-olds have different attitudes about social media, maybe age is making the difference. But it's also very likely that it has to do with the fact that the 80-year-olds spent most of their lives without the existence of social media, and for a 10-year-old, social media has already been there. So these are our two basic methods that we can use for developmental psychology. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask me, and I hope you all have a wonderful day.